Put a glass box around her and she'll break the glass. If you try to cage her in, she'll light the match. Well, she's like an animal, it's in her blood. She will turn every chain into dust, into dust, into dust. If you try to take what is in her blood,
Hey guys, this is Andre once again from Trap Nation. Hope you're all having an incredible year so far. With the success of the last... another one, but this time where we showcase our label Lowly Palace. Just a reminder as well, all music in this mix is free to use on YouTube if you include the artist's socials and a streaming or download link to the song in the description. That's enough talking for now though. Enjoy the mix, everyone.
Hello and welcome to another rousing round of Boise State Esports here from the Game Pants Arena in the heart of downtown Boise. My name is Adam Chizu McGuire, pulling double duty today as your host as well as your caster for the three rounds of games that we have for you today. Rocket League, League of Legends, and of course Overwatch. And thankfully I am joined by one of the best casters that the Treasure Valley has to offer, Lisa Jolly Malhas.
Oh, okay. So in practice I was the best, but now that we're actually on air, it's one of the best.
You did ask me to tone it down just a smidge.
Yeah, that's true. My humility comes out off camera, I suppose.
Just being humble, and that is all right. But thank you so much for stopping on in today. We've got a lot of action to go through, starting off with Rocket League. What can you tell some of our viewers tuning in through Twitch, as well as other instances? What can we come to see today?
For Rocket League, first off, Mountain West champions here in the house. We have the trophy and everything set up in the next room over. Lots of good stuff going today. This is going to be the first game that we have seen for both League of Legends and Rocket League today. Our Overwatch crew has had a little bit of practice as we had the Uncle Sam Summer Showdown last weekend, if I'm not mistaken. A great event. We'll be doing that quarterly also, if I'm not mistaken. So for those of you interested in coming and participating in one of those tournaments, keep an ear out. But for now, we're going to stick with strictly varsity stuff as we're facing off against Florida State today.
Yeah, tying in with the Boise State football kind of stuff. The Mountain West champions that you were bringing up, Cosmo Buster, LC Coro, and Ace Pocket, making their return today to try to continue that streak that they had. A very, very impressive run last season, looking to continue to do so, and that is probably spearheaded by the most smiley individual in all of esports, Cosmo Buster.
I cannot get enough of this guy. Honestly, he is the happiest dude, and he helps carry this team, and I don't want to say he carries this team at all, because each of these players is miraculously fantastic in their own way. Each of them has their own style and strategy that really adds to the team, but Cosmo's smile, you can tell, is just contagious, and it's hard not to be happy when you're sitting up there on the blue with him, on the blue turf.
Right, and the way that this team communicates is absolutely optimal for what they are trying to do. Whether it's Cosmo just having these sniper shots from the mid, or the replayability for the rest of his teammates to come in, the rebounds, as well as boost management, has been huge for this crew. So if they can continue to do what they've been doing, well, it looks like we are going to get right into it as we take on Florida State University. Your lineup for them is Ghost, Stupid Monkey, as well as Bruno.
A little bit of a difference. It looks like Icarus is going to hop in for Stupid Monkey. We still have B, though, which is Bruno. A great save there by Cosmo Buster. Going to do a little flip in celebration.
You see LC Coro here in the net. He's going to clear this on out and make sure that his team can kind of revamp their strategy here, coming up here on the left-hand side of the wall. Clearing that towards the mid. Ghost. Ace Pocket, Cosmo Buster. Burning a lot of boost to get there. Shot on goal is not enough as Icarus is able to turn that away. And now Boise State University on the defense.
Even using that much boost, though, each of these players knows that they have to keep it up as well. So it's not one thing just to use the boost in one go. You have to be able to recover from that if you don't make the goal or if you don't make the save. And great score. Ghost is going to be the first one on the board here less than a minute into this first game.
And Cosmo was in the wings. He was looking to get there. Kind of a weird land there from him. Was not able to get there in time. And that is going to be first points on the board for Florida State University. So Ghost netting the first of the series. This is a best of seven, so plenty of time to turn it around, not only in the game, but in the series as well.
And this is something that we've seen a lot from the Boise State crew, falling behind a little bit in the early game. And it's not as though it's their intention necessarily, it might be, though it is really to get a feel for the opposing team. They might give up a round or two. That's generally not the case. So they usually pick it up in the second half of the game here. But really getting a feel on the style of play. And Ghost is rocking it right now. That is going to be score number two up alongside LC Coro, who just could not prevent that ball from going
in. There were two individuals from Boise State University looking to get any kind of force on that ball, and unfortunately not able to do so. In favor of Florida State University, is Ghost is able to pick it up. Number two for him. LC Coro looking to get on the start of this play, but unfortunately going to end up back on the defensive side. And that was one of the things that we were going to touch on, Jolly, is that, yes, Boise State does have that mental prowess to kind of come back from a lower end set. But right now, it's looking pretty heavy for the Boise State crew. They need to turn something on, find some kind of communication, because these are happening, these goals anyways, by a matter of inches.
And a minute and a half in, two goals already on. This is not something that Boise State is normally used to. They at least kind of hold their own to start. But again, we've still got 3 minutes, 20 seconds left in this game, and that might be all they need to turn it around. Two goals, we have seen them make 3-4 in 30 seconds sometimes. So this is not a lost game, that's for sure. Two is nothing for the Boise State crew.
Absolutely, and Cosmo Buster looking to take a shot, but instead is a little too high. Ace Pocket with the follow-up off the crossbar is unable to net that one. So it'll mean that Florida State University now can move this ball into the offensive zone, and Boise State falls back on their heels. Ghost, who's already netted two, looking for a third, is not able to squeeze that by Ace Pocket, and Cosmo Buster unable to corral that. Means that Ace Pocket will follow up, putting it out towards the mid-offensive, and a great boot is going to put that right back in scary territory, just a little bit more to the left, and that would have gone straight in. Now an aerial play here, pushed away by Cosmo Buster. He's going to carry it up with the time machine car here, as it looks like instead going to get turned away. LC Coro going to save a shot on goal there.
And again, this being the first game of the season, we can already see a little bit of lackluster communication here from the Boise State crew. Oftentimes, Cosmo Buster and LC Coro, oh my goodness, both going for a save or a goal there, and one of them does get it, but it could interfere with the movement of another player there. So a good save by B, as we just saw, as Boise State is trying to keep it on the offensive side. We're getting close to 2 minutes here left on the clock, though, and there's a lot of aerial play going on.
And there was a little bit of a nice flick there. Ace Pocket trying to carry it up the right-hand side. Ghost is just going to bring this down. Is there a second touch? Icarus off the crossbar. Cosmo in the air is able to clear it for his team, and now they have a wide open net. Can they follow through? Cosmo Buster finds the win.
No assists needed there for Cosmo. We can see him rocking that thing across the entire field. Knocks it off the ground there, bounces it in. Nothing that Florida State could do there. Almost 2 minutes now left on the clock. I had just said we were coming down to 2 minutes, and that's what it took for Boise State to at least get 50% of the way to a tie here. So again, all is not lost, and even if they lose the first round, you'd be surprised to see where they come from in the next few.
Well, and that was all on the defensive side. Cosmo Buster carried that all the way in. A full committal there from Florida State University was actually turned around in a matter of seconds, and that's exactly what we were talking about when it comes to this Boise State crew. But we have seen that Florida State can take shots from any angle and find the net. So Boise State needs to take this in stride and understand that they can be attacked once again very, very quickly as we see B carry this up here on the left-hand side. There's nobody there. Cosmo finally showing up in time. Ace Pocket to carry it away. Shot on goal is wide left.
Ace Pocket already making some miraculous saves here. Elsie Corey, you can tell, is just trying to get back into his rhythm because he's one of those players that is all over the map all the time. And he, of all of them, really takes his time in figuring out the flow of the opposing team there. We're getting down to 1 minute. Now they're working on their rotations. You can see a much better rotations coming in. Elsie Corey trying to make a goal there, but two members of Florida State are going to prevent that from even being considered a shot.
Yeah, Ace Pocket is going to clear this back out as the rest of Boise State tries to reset here, collecting a bunch of boost if they can. Looks like Icarus going to clear this. And a little bit of bunch ball here on the right-hand side. Cosmo Buster looking to get this cleared out. B going to carry it down the mid. It is open. A destruction right there for LC Coro. A shot on goal is off the crossbar. Ace Pocket is also going to be destroyed here in the process by B. So Cosmo and LC Coro. Oh boy, a shot on goal off the crossbar. Icarus looking for another, and he finds it. Another one for Florida State University.
Ghost getting the assist on that one. That's going to be the first there for Icarus, though. Multiple shots on goal, just slightly high. And we can tell Boise State members, all three of them, I believe, attempted to go in for a save there. Missed the save. Thankfully, the crossbar was able to prevent that ball from going in, but not the final time when Icarus drove that thing home.
That demolition was unfortunate as it made it so one of the members of Boise State University had to respawn, opened up the net wide for the side of FSU. And now Boise State, LC Coro, going to try to put this up and over. Ghost is going to get a wheel on it. And now Boise State trying to find anything. Cosmo finds it. 5 seconds left on the clock. So there is still a chance.
There is. And this is round one out of seven. So there's obviously a good chance for Boise State to come back here. But there's also a chance for Florida State to really show their prowess if they are, in fact, the better players here. If they are, that means we better see them in one of the next conferences, one of the next tournaments. Because for now, we're the ones holding that trophy. But this appears to be a very well put together team. And I'm assuming this is their first game of the season as well.
Final seconds here on the board. This game does not end until that ball touches the ground. It looks like it will. First round going to FSU. They played a phenomenal game from the very, very beginning to the last handful of seconds. The communication between them looks to be absolutely spot on, and their shot direction is just as laser sight.
We got a minute left until the next match, so a little bit of communication going on between these teams. And see if they can kind of figure out exactly what their method to the madness that we kind of saw there would be running into the next round.
And that's kind of one of the things we talked about is Boise State likes to take this kind of like a puzzle, a jigsaw. You kind of get the outside area going, then you start to fill in the center pieces. Next thing you know, you have a beautiful picture of like, I don't know, a horse or something, you know? And that's what Boise State really enjoys doing. They really enjoy finding out where their limits are, where the opponents like to play, and then they fill in the rest. And again, they get a beautiful horse.
I get it, because it's a Bronco, right?
Exactly.
It's a horse. I see where you're going with that one. And that is a pretty good analogy to make with this team, because going straight into it, as soon as we saw that first goal in less than a minute, we acknowledged that, yeah, Boise State tends to kind of fall behind, and then they become relentless right. The following games. I mean, we've seen 10-plus rounds or 10-plus scores from Boise State in a single round, and that is after losing one or two rounds as well. So they really just have to find their rhythm, find their flow. And once that clicks, I'd be scared for Florida State.
Yeah, absolutely. The mental momentum needs to arrive for this Boise State crew. And they've got plenty of games to do it. As we jump into game number two here, Florida State University up one. LC Coro getting the first touch here. Looks like Cosmo coming up as well.
Woo!
Nice redirection. LC Coro to try to follow up. Unfortunately, not able to find the crossbar, but is accredited with a shot on goal.
Cosmo was. LC Coro looks like was interfering. I think he was trying to drive that home because he knew somebody was there. But Cosmo already taking these line drives. We can see he is determined to get that first goal in, and he wants to do it in under a minute. LC Coro going to get the demolition on Icarus to start this one off, and Cosmo Buster already recognizing that he's going to have to go on the defensive on this ball to ensure that it stays in the offensive zone for the most part of this game.
Absolutely, and that was a great start there from Boise State University, but now Florida State is on the attack. Demolition once again for Boise State University. Tried to clear up the right-hand side, but instead will find the ball in neutral territory. Turned back around by FSU. Elsie Coral now on the wall, left the goal kind of open, but thankfully Cosmo Buster is there to corral that. A nice single touch there. We'll put the ball back into more of a neutral position as Florida State continues to put pressure on.
4 minutes now. Nobody made a first goal in the first minute. We tend to see that very often when it comes to these Boise State games, whether it is them making the score or them a little floundering, if you will, when it comes to the opposing team scoring on them consistently. So we'll see how long it takes. Once that first goal goes in, I'm not sure what it is about this team, but they just keep coming, whether it's from one side or the other. These are never 0-1 rounds. They are always 2+ on either side, generally.
Absolutely. Ace Pocket was waiting in the wings. He's going to put a touch on this. Elsie Coral coming to strike, but is turned away there by Florida State University. And now Ace Pocket needs to pull back. Icarus pulling this one on the left-hand side. The thing about Florida State is that they've got a shot on goal and cleared away by the two members of Boise State, but they are able to shoot from wherever they want, but they prefer that stuff kind of mechanic, rolling it up the left-hand or right-hand side of the wall, trying to force it on in, as Boise State has put two individuals in front of the net in multiple instances, and they have still been challenged on those shots. So something that they need to keep their eyes open for and kind of aware of, as if, you know, they weren't already, that this team is going to take a shot. It's turned away! Ace Pocket there with the last-minute save, and the savior halo is very appropriate. Boise State, once again, on the defensive, needs to find a way to turn this out and around. Cosmo Buster is able to scoop it on the low, and it looks like Boise State is very, very bunched together. They're forced to be on that defensive more times than they would like. B turns that one away. A second touch by LC. It is found, and Boise State strikes first.
Cosmo, we can see with the assist there, lining that one up. B with an incredible save there, but not enough to prevent Elsie Coro from rebounding that one back in. We can see him get a little touch there as Ghost kind of boops him away from that goal. One in Boise State's favor. Almost half of this round gone before a single goal goes in, though. So either way, this is a great rivalry that I can see coming up again in the future.
Yeah, a slower start here as Ghost clears that out. It's actually a pretty good shot on goal. Hits the top right corner, but is not going to find the back of the net. As Boise State now is given possession of this ball, Cosmo coming off the wall, trying to find his feet, and he does. Ace Pocket going to clear this up. Cosmo with a top touch, and Ace Pocket is in the wings waiting. Elsie Cora went to challenge, but that is a wide open net on the Boise State side, and it barely misses the net just to the left. Now Boise State clearing this back up as FSU falls back on their heels. The big boost picked up there from Boise State. That's definitely going to help. Elsie Coral just waiting in his defensive side, looking for any opportunity. Shot on goal. This could be a good one. B is going to clear this out of the way off the top bar. Ace Pocket not able to get a touch on it as Cosmo looking for a second attempt. He will find it. Ace Pocket pushed out of the way, but Elsie Coral brings this right back for Boise State University as Elsie Coral will kind of slow play down for a half second as Ace Pocket going to fall back. Cosmo Buster is going to turn that one back around.
All of these incredible saves have been made by B on that end. So he's been staying not strictly in the defensive zone, but mostly in that defensive zone because of how well he can knock that ball away. Ghost, on the other hand, we've seen so many shots on goal come from this guy. He is absolutely incredible at riding it down the line and getting it hit towards that net.
And Ghost has already put up two on the board in that first round, so definitely an eye needed to be kept on him. Cosmo Buster flicks it over the top. It's going for the corner. Is not able to find it. Ace Pocket here aerially is going to block that and stop it in the neutral area over the head of Ace Pocket. As the ball kind of comes to a stop, Cosmo Buster booting it back out, but is found there by Ghost. 1 minute remains now, and it looks like Boise State has a shred of hope putting this to a 1-1. All they have to do is stabilize for the next 50 seconds or so. Looks like Icarus carrying this up. Cosmo Buster going to try to clear this thing out, but instead it looks like Ghost has found it. Ace Pocket now just holding on to the wall, trying to make sure that there are no free goals. A demolition there from Icarus. A shot on goal carried up by Ace Pocket. Trying to... Oh, a third touch! It took three touches, but he got it!
This is where we see the communication from Boise State really coming through. Ace Pocket peeling away from the defensive side after he saw Elsie Cora was going to get the push back to their offensive. So he moved out. He was able to follow that one through. We could see him kind of reeling back as he saw that first shot was definitely going to be high. The second one, he wasn't so certain, but he made sure that just in case he was in the right position to drive it home. He's trying to take another one there. Still 2-0 in Boise State's favor. Florida State needs to get two on the board to keep this one going.
FSU commits really hard right there, putting two members very far forward. But here comes Ace Pocket, wide open net!
And B almost there in time to save it as well. I don't know if you saw the timing on this one.
But look at how much net is here. That's a wide open net. Ace
that
Pocket
turn.
Just gives it. Whoop!
that perfect turn from B, that was actually incredible. I'm really impressed with this guy's defensive play right now.
Yeah, well, and the entirety of Florida State University has been looking really, really good. They've been putting Boise State on their heels in more instances than one. And if they can carry it in, so can Boise State. And we are seeing it right here as LC Coro is going to try to clear this out. 10 seconds remain. This is kind of a dire situation for Florida State University. Whether or not they can turn this around is very questionable. But it does look like Boise State will tie this up. Final seconds on the board. This game, again, does not end until that ball hits the ground. So it looks like Cosmo and friends going to just spike it down. Boise State taking round number one to much enlightened claps from the crew here. But there it is, Boise State picking up their first win, tying the series up at 1-1. Jolly, what did you see in the second round that maybe was missing in the first round?
I mean, just the rotations coming from Boise State is the biggest thing I think that we see get cleaned up. We can see their Florida State University players ghosts. We have Alec Chrysler, Bruno, Brett Walker, Icarus is Lucas Prodromou.
If I mispronounce,
you know, you guys can always correct me in chat. I won't be able to fix it now because I can't see chat, but I'll go back later and be like, oh man. Yeah. So the communication when it comes to the rotations, though, we saw a lot of situations where Florida State was able to take advantage of Boise State in that first round when nobody was around the goal. But there was always somebody there this time. There was always somebody at least in the area to turn it back around, right. Just like we saw Florida State do really well in that first round. Really one member sitting back, two on that offensive rotation. Boise State tends to take a moment or so to do that. And again, it might even be part of their strategy in falling behind a little bit, just letting the opposing team get their flow in so they can really see what the strategies are, what they're putting in place before it gets to round two. So we already see three goals put on, I believe one from each player there on Boise State. LC Cora was the first one. Ace Pocket getting the MVP for that last round. But either way, we've got ourselves a game.
Absolutely. With the series tied at 1-1, best of seven, there's plenty more game to play. And personally, I did like what I saw from Florida State University as well. Yes, it was the first game in which they absolutely dominated and decimated within the first 60 seconds. But they're playing great Rocket League right now. They're doing a good job defensively. Offense, they showed us game one. Defense, they showed us game two. Sure, they were scored on, but there were some beautiful plays. You mentioned B's little power slide, almost last minute save. Could be a situation that Boise State needs to look out for as we jump here into game number three. Again, a best of seven series, so plenty of ball to be played. As it looks like Cosmo Buster watches it go right by. A second touch is not there, unfortunately, for FSU, and turned away for Boise State as Ace Pocket is going to recollect himself.
It looks like B almost had that one and then didn't really follow through. Ghost is going to try to make the best of it, though, and Icarus is going to follow that up. That's going to be score one, 4 minutes and 20 seconds on the board. Florida State, less than a minute, already getting themselves on there.
That all started from a very, very strong opening couple seconds from the side of Florida State University. They had the pressure, they had the ball, and they are trying to just stuff it, which leaves the net wide open on either side. And Boise State, unfortunately, not able to reconcile that issue. It's one of those things where everybody likes to be in the way, but not everyone can. And another great kind of stuff turnaround across is in. What a shot from Ghost.
Icarus this time getting the assist on that one. A little bit of a flip-flop. We can see here Ace Pocket trying to get it back. Ghost taking the opportunity of an open net and making sure that one goes in. Yeah, a great angle there. And that's the nice thing about this vehicle, Octane, is that you can really hit it from any angle. You can see it's relatively rounded. It's not one of the flatter cars. The flatter ones have generally a better acceleration. They're better for making the car fly across the field. But if you're looking for a side hit, maybe a little bit less precise, but it can go any angle, that is going to be your Octane.
And Cosmo Buster in the net is going to let that one fly right by. A little bit of a scary situation there is Ghost once again carrying this up. We have seen them score from this area, but Ace Pocket is there to flick it out of there. So now Boise State trying to carry it up. Cosmo goes roaring by, and now B once again has it. Cosmo has to slow down, but we got a little bit of bunch ball going on here. This is one of the things that Boise State has needed to work on since minute one. Everybody wants to get their hands on this ball or wheels, whatever one you want, as Cosmo and LC are trying to make a play here. A demolition here for Icarus is going to send LC Coro back to the respawn point. Ghost going to follow up. That means Cosmo by himself is going to take a shot and be turned away by B.
No surprise there, B, the savior with that halo. Great offense, though, from Boise State. Even with two members down for a few seconds, Cosmo was able to follow that one up. And it's not necessarily the grouping, because you can tell that this team is trying to do everything, but when they do get close together, they try to kind of rearrange themselves. But oh my goodness.
What a one-timer.
B be going to get an assist on this guy. Ghost picking that one up, though.
So watch the cross right here, and straight to Ghost over the head of LC Coro and into the short side of the net is going to mean 3-0 for Florida State. They have taken control of game number three here. Ace Pocket now trying to start things out, is going to clear it out, but it ends up on the Boise State side. So now we are seeing Boise State kind of unraveling at the seams. They have taken a couple of shots, but this game has been predominantly dominated by the side of Florida State University. A couple of bunch ball plays, as I've said, as well as a little bit of weird miscommunication and some beautiful shots there on the side of Florida State University has led them to a 3-0 lead here in round number three.
It's really these incredible clear, oh my goodness, and another one off the front of Ace Pocket there. Icarus going to pick up an assist, and Ghost again really making a name for himself in this game. A great lineup there. We can see it come off that crossbar on the left-hand side. Ghost going to drive that one home. So really, really incredible play. I was saying these clears that they are performing are quite amazing. When Boise State seems to be in control and really just dribbling the ball straight across, they are running it down. Somebody from Florida State comes out of nowhere and knocks that thing all the way across the field.
Yeah, the long ball is looking really good here for Florida State University, and Boise State right now has just been doing their dangdest to try to get everything collected, trying to get some points on the board, but unfortunately it just does not seem to be coming together here in this game number three, as Cosmo and the rest of his crew going to clear this one out hard, as Cosmo Lester is looking for a rebound, is not going to find it, instead peels off for the largest of the boosts as LC Coral brings this ball to a standstill. Looks like B going to carry it out as well. That is a wide open Boise net, and that is going to hit the crossbar off the right hand side. If there is a god, you believe in him if you're a Boise State fan, because that would have been a fifth point right there for the side of Florida State University. Wide open net, and somehow they are unable to get it in the back of the net. So Ace Pocket going to carry this through. Icarus is in the wings. LC Coro is just waiting for his chance, instead going to peel back and defensively set himself up. Ace Pocket aerially not able to get a touch on that, is now going to find himself picking up the big boost on the right hand side. Ghost clearing this up. We have seen them score from this area before. Ace Pocket, though, is going to clear it out. B and Ghost resetting here on the right hand side. LC Coro going to pick up the big one as Ace Pocket. That's a very scary situation. LC Coro is now the focus of our camera angle. He's going to clear this back out up against the wall, and that is a great clear. Cosmo Buster left with the wide open net, is unable to commit as much as he would like. That ball's coming off the right hand side. Ace Pocket with the setup is not able to find it, and instead is going to peel back as well.
A lot of these aerial hits coming from Boise State, we can see where they are trying to get the ball to hit, but maybe it's the vehicle they're using, it's just not going the direction they want it to. It's constantly going at a pretty strong angle, either up or down, and so they really can't send that ball as close to the net, even so that a team member can play off of a rebound. It ends up just being cleared by Florida State.
Another one of those left-hand stuffs was being sought out by Florida State University, but was too far, so Boise State now will have an opportunity to put some points on the board. 30 seconds left on this. Looks like LC Coral going to take out Icarus, looking to clear up that goal, and unfortunately not able to get a touch as Boise State University. They'll clear it back. Ace Pocket trying to get a shot on goal, immediately turned away. LC Coro off the wall, is not able to do what he was looking to do. So now this leaves it in the hands of Cosmo Buster, setting up. He is up and over. A shot on goal is wide right. LC Coro is going to find it. Boise State on the board with 15 seconds left. It may be too little too late, but dang, it feels good.
At least getting one on there definitely feels good, especially when they are up four goals at this point. It is, again, only round three, you know, a maximum of seven that we could see here today, but Boise State is not going to give up that easily.
Not at all. They've definitely got plenty of time to keep going, but this one may already be in the books. Florida State, again, up three goals with 15 seconds to go, and Boise State needs to find something, and they need to find it fast, or they will be at a 2-1 deficit as we move on to the next round. Pushing it down is Ace Pocket. Cosmo Buster looking for a shot on goal. That's a pretty beautiful one, but it's turned away there by B at the last second, and that is going to be round number three. Looks like they want to keep playing just a little bit as Ace Pocket going to keep this ball alive. Cosmo Buster not able to get a touch there, but B will continue to carry it. The ball hits round three to Florida State University.
All right, I've got to say, I've got a personal MVP. Sorry. A personal MVP for this game. I mean, just so far in all three rounds, he has made it almost impossible for Boise State to get that ball past being in the offensive zone. The second it's there, he's got his eyes locked on that ball, and he is going to make sure that it does not get close enough to the goal for somebody to be able to make a rebound off of that. He has been so good at forcing those clears and allowing the rest of his team to stay on the offensive, and he's even gone off onto Boise State's side every so often, and they have a great rotation rotation coming around, so he feels comfortable as well leaving the defense into any other member's hands.
And speaking of players to watch out for, Ghost has been unstoppable, putting in shots from angles that you have no business doing so, as well as the defensive prowess of this whole Florida State team.
And then I think Icarus has gotten an assist on pretty much every single one of those goals, I think he ended up getting one of those goals, but Ghost has taken every other one for himself in this one. And every member of Boise State has been on the board. We saw last round LC Coro take one home. So, you know, they're finding their footing, or they're wheeling. it's going to be a bad day today, guys.
They're
finding their grip so far on this game. And four rounds potentially left to go, so long as Boise State doesn't give up the following two.
Well, and we mentioned that they are a come-from-behind team, but right now I'm seeing a lot of problematic things for the side of Boise State University. A lot of bunch ball, a lot of individuals stacking on top of each other. We're seeing two individuals in the net, and Florida State University is still capable of squeezing that ball through the post. I'm not sure if that's just happenstance, if that's just luck, if it's kind of the way things are going, or if it is really one of those worrisome situations.
And look at the determination there that we see on Cosmo's face. Those smiles still appear, but you'll notice he's a little more concentrated than we normally see him at this point in the game. We can see a lot of communication going on between these players, a lot of shots being called out, in particular by Cosmo, who I believe is the captain of the team this year.
Yeah, it very well could be the case as we get here into round number four. 2-1 in favor of Florida State University. Boise State has definitely come back from larger deficits. Your returning Mountain West Conference champions. Shot on goal is not going to be found. LC Coro there going to be credited with it. Another shot off the crossbar is not going to roll in as Cosmo is trying his best, as well as the rest of the Boise State Broncos, but they're going to clear here for a center.
Every member they're getting a shot on goal. Granted, I think only one of them was considered being save there.
And it looks like we have a little bit of a technical difficulty here, so there's probably a lot of Rocket League happening behind us. Again, I'm not entirely sure what is going on with our side of things.
Hey, there we go.
There it is.
It's a quick pause, I believe.
Clear there, and it looks like Cosmo Buster and the rest of the crew are still managing that 0-0, 3:30 left here in the game. As Ace Pocket going to destroy B here, LC Coro credited with that save. As Ghost taking another shot, that's one of those weird angles that he has found success from. LC Coro trying to clear this out, but the rest of Florida State University is there. Ace Pocket trying to go down the center, just going to ram it through, is not able to, and B buries that.
Okay, that was insane. I don't know if you guys saw B. Oh, there's almost a goal. B coming across. He noticed he had to go on the defensive. He turned mid-air as he was going the opposite direction and knew exactly where the ball was going to be, so his eyes on that ball are insane.
And B with another shot. LC Coro is going to turn that one away. B is all over the place and looking to score, but LC Coro going to push that away from his front bumper as Ghost now carries it up the top. Ace Pocket with a touch. That was almost a setup. That is a very good clear there. Cosmo Buster going to be turned away by B, though, as the rest of Boise State University now rotates up, tries to get this ball turned to a side that is favorable for them, as Ace Pocket here is going to kind of corral it, pushed out of the way there by Ghost, and now LC Coro is on the top of that thing and is able to clear it for his side. It looks like Boise State trying to get some kind of setup here. We see Ace Pocket in the mid is not able to get a touch on that, unfortunately, and that is one of the things that we have been seeing for Boise State is just too little and not enough as far as the ball touches are concerned. Ace Pocket is going to get in the way of that shot. Cosmo Buster going to carry this one here on the ground. They've kind of noticed that the aerial play is in favor of Florida State University. A shot is going to be found. Aerial play, as I was talking about it. Icarus, with a great return, is going to find the first one here in round number four. Just off the wall. If you tell me he meant to get that, you are a liar, sir. As that one finds the left-hand side and is good to go.
You know, I don't count anything out of these guys' hands when it comes to watching some of the pros play and some of the shots they make and some of the saves they are able to achieve here. I mean, I'm not going to say he didn't intend to do that at all. So we're getting close to 2 minutes now on the clock. LC Coro really doing his best to corral that ball over to the play going in favor of the opposing team from Boise State. They normally just rock that aerial play, so they're working on getting the lower ground clears in hopes that it will send the ball across without giving an aerial opportunity over. Great save there by Icarus, preventing Ace Pocket's shot from going in. Another one by Cosmo Buster. They're all just trying to get themselves lined up for a goal here. Ace Pocket almost bringing it around for a potential follow-up from a teammate there, but not quite enough as Cosmo Buster lines up next.
Cosmo with the cross to LC Caro. Ace Pocket is on the right-hand side. If they can get this up, he could put it in. It's up and down and is not going to find it as Ghost going to save that one. Another shot on goal. Ariel is above the net, but not going to find what he's looking for. Ace Pocket with a touch that goes behind him. He did not like that. Here comes LC Caro, and it goes right over the top of his car. Cosmo Buster able to take another touch at this as Ace Pocket looking to redirect this is not able to as Cosmo Buster puts another close shot on goal. Passed over to LC Caro. The shot is turned away by Icarus, and now Boise State only has 60 seconds left to try to stop the bleeding. Ace Pocket is going to find it!
Cosmo Buster getting the assist on that one. Let us take another look at that beautiful play. Just an attempt at all of these to line something up for Ace to knock that one home. And he found exactly where he needed to there, just in the corner and just beyond the grasp of Florida State's vehicles.
I was talking about needing some stitches, and Boise State shows up with the whole first aid kit. And now we have ourselves a game here in round number 3. Oh, almost came off of LC Coral. What a beautiful touch there. Turned away by Ghost, an even more immaculate save. Ace Pocket with another shot here. Ghost, it's over his head, and Ace Pocket looking to turn this around. LC Coral has a chance. He is not able to find it as that tinks right off the crossbar. Ace Pocket looking to probably put this towards Cosmo Buster. Cosmo is instead going to try to neutralize this ball as it looks like FSU now has an opportunity to win this game. And it is turned away. Ace Pocket just saved round number 4 and possibly the series here for Boise State University. Another great shot there from Florida State University in an area that they did not deserve to have a shot in as Ace Pocket now falls to the ground. Is he able? He's not. Ghost out of nowhere finds a middle shot and drills it on home. That's exactly what I was talking about. You see this ball just drop too quick, and unfortunately Ace Pocket not able to get himself there. A little bit of an over-rotation. That means that Florida State University is 8 seconds away from taking this round. Can Boise State find some signs of life? They have shown it throughout the course of these last 4 rounds. Cosmo Buster is aerial and is looking for something, but is unable to find it. Boise State University is unable to turn it around, so another round for Florida State University. We are now at game point, 3-1 in favor of Florida State University.
Boise State's not used to getting this far behind, that's for sure. We can see a little bit of hydration going on here. They're trying to figure out exactly what needs to be done to improve the play style here. But look, I mean, still smiles across all of their faces, still having a great time, and it's actually really nice for this team to have somebody to go up against that they feel like they are not just absolutely decimating, because we have seen Boise State win these games in double digits with zero on the other side. They just run over some of the opponents, and this is a team, this is a school, Florida State University, that is really holding up.
Yeah, absolutely, and that's one of those things that Boise State University needs to kind of keep in the back of their head. Yes, you have, you know, you are the returning champions. Maybe this is one of those instances where you go, oh, wow, these guys are a lot better than we thought, because as of right now, I'm not seeing a glaring hole in the side of Boise State University. Rather, Florida State University is taking shots from areas that they would never anticipate a shot coming from, and they are finding the back of the net, as well as the stuff mechanics that they were doing before, working absolutely pivotally for the side of Florida State University. BSU needs to find something, and they need to find it now.
And it's one of the few times we actually see this grouping strategy work. Not that it's a strategy, it's usually disadvantageous to a team if they can't or if they start grouping up, generally means their communication is not quite on point, means their rotations are not where they need to be, but this team is running away with it. We see all three grouped up, but not once have they knocked another member out of the way of being able to make a shot on goal or out of the way of defending that goal. And now all members, I was saying B as the savior, but that last game was all Ghost on the defensive side.
Like I said, Ghost was the one I was trying to keep my eyes on, but it's hard when he's so translucent. Going to get a demolition right there. Cosmo Buster trying to stuff that one and is not going to be able to. Ace Pocket, newly revived, is going to turn that over to Cosmo Buster. What a shot!
No way!
What a shot! From the defensive end, the long ball is found by Cosmo Buster, and watch this, a boop, it finds the net. Boise State off to a great start, 25 seconds in, and maybe they just keep doing that. Maybe they keep playing the long ball. Maybe they stop with the 2 and 3 touches, because that right there was absolutely beautiful.
That's where Florida State is really getting a lot of their hits, is these long shots, so why not try to take advantage of the same situations as Boise State? And Cosmo, I'm pretty sure every couple of weeks in the season, we see him on a new vehicle, and this is exactly why, because he knows just what to do and what strategies to take with with each style of car. So he nailed that one perfectly. That flat end knew exactly what his rotation was going to be and it nailed it. So 4 minutes, less than a minute in again, and we're seeing a goal. This is more like the Boise State that we've seen the past seasons.
Absolutely, and as they run this here on the right-hand side, Cosmo Bus are going to be destroyed there by Icarus. We'll mean a few seconds he's going to be hanging out, but Ace Pocket here is looking to make a move. LC Coro off to the left-hand side. They're just going to let B carry this up here on the left-hand side of the wall, trying to keep his eyes on it. Right here is Ace Pocket. A shot there from Ghost is not going to happen. Turned away. Ace Pocket is off to the races. Off the wall. Can he carry this in? B is going to just nail that against the wall. LC Coro now looking for a cross. Cosmo Buster is sort of there, but is not able to. So he is instead going to peel off to the left-hand side. Great stop there. Puts the ball back onto the offensive side for Boise State University.
A lot of the issues that we were seeing with Boise State the first one, maybe two rounds there, or I guess they won the second one. So the first one and then three rounds there, we're kind of starting to see show up for Florida State now that Boise State is really getting into the flow of things. I would not be surprised if this match went out to seven rounds.
Absolutely. And again, LC Coro, Cosmo Buster, and Ace Pocket just trying to do the best they can. They need to follow this up and are not able to, as Ghost is going to be accredited with the first four at Florida State University. And again, as you were talking about the issues not necessarily being there, it was one of those ones where, again, it's just too little too late for the side of Boise State University. We're seeing a lot of just millimeters worth of ball getting by, and that is more than enough for the side of Florida State University, because if it goes in, it still counts. So Boise State is again back on the defensive side here. LC Coro looking to do something. He's just going to carry this down. He's not able to flick it over B, but instead Ace Pocket going to find an opening. He's going to put that off on the right hand side. LC Coro here is not going to be able to make a touch as Icarus boots that back towards Boise State's goal. Cosmo Buster, playing a more defensive game this time around, is going to push that over the top, and as I say it, he starts to move his way onto the offense, carrying it up over and around. No one there to find it though, and it looks like LC Coro going to attempt, not able to find anything on that challenge, and it's these weird bounces that are causing Boise State so much problem.
And Boise State has had no boost so far this round, or at least the past minute of this round. Anytime they go, they end up using 100-0 on their boost, and by the time they actually get it onto that offensive side, they don't have the movement and the momentum necessary to follow
wow.
it through. A demolition there is going to remove LC Coro from the fight for the next couple of seconds. A great shot there coming through from Ace Pocket.
Oh.
B with another save under his belt.
But it's not done yet. LC Coro to Cosmo Buster, not able to commit on that one. So LC is going to peel back, pick up the big boost, and now they're back on the defensive side. A great offensive move there from B. He's able to put it over the top of Boise State University. That ball is spiked down. Cosmo Buster kicks it on out. Back to Ghost, who is now going to look for yet another goal. He's had so many on this series already, but instead it is cleared out, and Cosmo is in the wings as they continue on the back and forth, and LC Coro gets a wheel on that one. Ace Pocket looking to continue on. It's a touch over the top on the crossbar, not able to get there. LC Coro unable to corral it, but is going to put it on the left-hand side. That should mean FSU has the move.
And while LC Coro is the player that usually is in the right place, always at the right time, Cosmo is the one that takes a quick look at the field and knows exactly where to go, but we're seeing a bit of him running back and forth kind of thing, which we are not used to seeing from this player. He does get a great save there, preventing Florida State from at least taking advantage in this one. But he's trying to take a quick look at the field, and these FSU players are all over the place. He doesn't know exactly where to go to get the advantage or the upper hand on these plays.
Cosmo was demolished there as you were talking about him, which led to Boise State pushing this one up on the offensive side. We got ourselves a tie game here, so we could be seeing some extra minutes. Very, very possible here. Ace Pocket to LC Coro, now going to give it the little touch. That shot is on goal, and it is going to be high and wide as Cosmo Buster now was in the goal, is now on the attack. LC Coro looking to make a move here. Cosmo is going to take out B. A play off of the wall here. Is there any kind of rebound? And it looks like a shot on goal by Ace Pocket is going to go in!
An attempted save there by B. Not going to be enough, if anything. Just reinforces that goal here.
And
actually, Ghost was the one who was attempting to get that one out. Almost did. We saw it bump off the top bar there. So had it been a little bit earlier, he may have been able to bounce that one out. But with that much force going through, it is difficult to stop that ball. Now sitting at 35 seconds. Not much time for Boise State to try to hold on to this one, because if they do end up getting scored on two times, that will be the end of the match.
Oh, LC Coro was given a nice feed there, was not able to finish the play, unfortunately, as it looks like Ace Pocket now is the only one here for the side of Boise State University and needs to get in position. That ball is up and high, and it looks like Boise State University is just going to let it drop. They're going to try to keep it here in the corner as you see B and Ghost, and Icarus is going to find it. We got ourselves a tie game.
Now 10 seconds left on the board. This is This has been an absolutely insane round of matches here. Icarus, again, going to take that one for himself. He and Ghost really bouncing back and forth on that offensive side. Boise State going to need to do everything that they can to make this one sink. Otherwise, they'll end up going into overtime. That's going to be a first goal. And if Boise State doesn't sink it, the match will be over.
Absolutely. And right now, Boise State looking for something, but it goes in, and that is it.
0 seconds in the game.
Florida State University with a final shot in the final seconds will find the match and the win here tonight. What a crazy shot there from B, and that is that. But, you know, it happens. It's one of those situations where you play the best that you can, and Florida State just looked absolutely flawless today.
That is going to be a team that we are going to want to play over and over and over again. Boise State's favorite thing, in particular in Rocket League, when it comes to finding a team that rarely has the advantage over them, all they want to do is play just so that they can learn and adapt and understand maybe what is new for this season, what may have changed last season. And I don't believe Florida State was one of those teams that we played up against very much, if at all. So great to see a start, you know, a little bit of a rough start for Boise State.
Right.
Not bad. It was definitely back and forth. You could tell Florida State was playing their hearts out.
Yeah, and again, it was one of those situations where I feel that Boise State University did the best that they could with what they were given, and unfortunately, it just wasn't enough. Again, a matter of inches, millimeters, whatever.
0 seconds.
Yeah, 0 seconds even at that point, it ended up being the situation. But that is just the first piece of everything that we have lined up for you today. So Florida State University picking up the Rocket League portion of tonight's festivities, and we will be back in the very near future with the League of Legends portion of this broadcast. Stay tuned.
Turn around, keep that whole shit underground.